conference will now begin. Please put your hands together and welcome onto the stage Dr. Brian Goon, Vice Chairman and President of XPeng. La conférence de presse va maintenant commencer. Veuillez accueillir chaleureusement le Dr. Brian Go, Vice Chairman et Président de XPeng.
I'm very thrilled to be here in Paris because this is the first time XPeng is attending the Paris Motor Show. So allow me to take this opportunity to share with you our story. XPeng is a young company. In fact, we just celebrated our 10th anniversary this August. We're also a company with a very unique DNA by automotive standards. Our founders came from internet, software, AI, as well as automotive backgrounds. Almost 40% of our total employees are in the area of R&D, and with majority of them in the fields of software and AI. From day one, XPeng's vision has always wanted to be the explorer of future mobility. Our belief is clear and simple. Technology and intelligence will be the ultimate driving force transforming mobility. And that is why XPeng has been building a deep technology stack to develop mobility solutions, from smart EV today, to flying cars, to even humanoid robots. We come from the world's largest and the most competitive EV market, China. In just 10 years, the Chinese new energy vehicle penetration as new car sales has grown from less than 1.1% to now over 50%. And also during that period, we saw the number of new energy vehicle competitors in China has gone from hundreds to less than 10% of our number today. So in this fiercely competitive market, XPeng has emerged to be the front runner. The numbers speak for themselves. Our cumulative delivery has exceeded 500,000. In the first 9 months of this year, we've delivered close to 100,000 vehicles, and in just past months alone, we delivered over 21,000. But to be a front runner, you also need to lead the major innovations and set new trends in the global EV transition, which we have done. Just to name a few, we were the first company to launch an advanced ADAS for both highway and cities. It's a feature now becoming increasingly important for premium EVs in China. We also introduced China's first high-voltage silicon carbide platform in a mass-produced vehicle, which significantly improved charging speed. In fact, every XPeng model at its launch, from the sporty P7 and the flagship G9 SUV to the most recent successful launch of X9 and Mona 03, has always incorporated the best-in-class smart technology that set us apart and sets the trend for the whole industry to follow. So thanks to our relentless focus on innovation, XPeng smartification features are at least one generation ahead of most EVs in the market. For example, the XPeng Navigation Guided Pilot, which we call NGP, provides nationwide autonomous driving coverage regardless of cities, routes, and road conditions. And by the end of this year, we can expect door-to-door NGP experience to be accomplished. Our Tianji OS is the proprietary operating system. It's voice assistant powered by our self-developed XGPT large AI model, can reason and anticipate your requests through natural conversations. And for a safer driving experience, Tianji also has the best-in-class surrounding reality navigation. And finally, our hassle-free monthly OTA updates is among the most frequent and the most powerful in the industry. We're the only Chinese company that can push beta tests to global users to collect their feedback. And in fact, our many innovations also has led to the strategic collaboration with Volkswagen Group. Our collaboration began with a joint development two electric SUV models for the Volkswagen brand in China based on our G9 platform. This partnership has since expanded to include collaboration on electric and electronic architecture for Volkswagen's China EV platforms. So this partnership also set the trend for technical partnerships between a Chinese EV brand and global automotive manufacturer to share technologies and co-develop models. Now let's switch to our global expansion. We have always aspired to be a global company. As early as 2017, when we're just a small startup in China, we have established our first R&D center in Silicon Valley. In 2020, we landed in Norway and embarked on a global expansion. And today, we are already selling our products in over 30 countries and regions. Our goal is to, by the end of 2025, to reach over 60 markets and become the number one Chinese premium EV brand in overseas markets. And in the long run, we expect half of our sales globally to come from outside of China. So to achieve this goal, Europe is definitely our core focus. We have a long-term commitment here, and we have more dedicated resources in Europe than any other region. This includes our established offices in Europe, our hundreds of sales locations, and we have an exciting European pipeline of products, of new models and facelifts to be launched in this market. We're also testing advanced ADAS function across Europe, trying to bring the best mobility technology here. And also we're investing into brand building, after sales services, training, as well as developing local infrastructure. So that is our story and journey so far. But let's talk about what's next. And with our tech DNA, Xpeng is ready again to set the next mega trend in mobility. So coming to share his vision and roadmap is someone very special and very integral to Xpeng's success. So please welcome onto stage our Chairman and CEO, Mr. He Xiaopeng.
Just a little happy, yeah. And welcome everyone to our lunch. For this session, I will deliver my presentation in Chinese. So, 大家好，我是何小鹏。那么，小鹏汽车跟我的名字是同一个名字，在中国这样的公司很少，但是在欧洲这样的公司非常多。我相信用自己的名字命名一家企业。 这既是责任也是使命。刚刚 Ryan 介绍了小鹏汽车在过去十年的一些情况，那么让我来今天来介绍一下这个小鹏汽车在下一个十年的一些思考。我们在过去的十年到二十年里面，我们看到了在全球从功能手机到智能手机的变化，以及从汽油汽车正在逐步向新能源汽车的变化，以及看到了 AI 的崛起。 所以，对于小鹏汽车来说，我们的目标是在下一个十年，希望面向全球做 AI 汽车，这也是小鹏汽车下一个十年的目标。所以大家可以看到，我们的图片里面，在最底层我们有自研的图灵芯片和我们的大模型。我们相信芯片跟将来未来的 OS， 也就是 大模型 OS， 是所有在 AI 公司的基础底座之一。 那么在这个上面，我们会开发汽车，将来现在是 AI 汽车，将来我们期望是无人驾驶汽车，它在城市内部可以轻松、安全、自动的运行。另外，我们相信在未来的十年，在全球会逐渐出现更多的低空飞行交通工具。那么我们在过去的时间，小鹏汽车花了十年去做研发，我们计划在今年的12月份。 开始预售，并且在2026年开始交付第一个面向中国跟全球的低空飞行交通产品以及机器人。所以这是面向十年小鹏期望在未来出行、未来交通以及在 AI 上的探索。那么在今天，我想和大家首先介绍小鹏在面向全球的首款 AI 汽车小鹏的 T7+。那么它将全面搭载
最领先的智能科技。 那么下面我想邀请大家先来看一条视频。
这就是我们的小鹏的 P7+。很多朋友问，为什么我们说 P7+是一款面向全球的第一款 AI 汽车？我想在这里跟大家分享一个小小的故事。在二三十年以前，我们都认为计算机互联网是一个专业的选择学习的一个科目，但是在今天，我们来看到计算机跟互联网。 在很多的领域是标准的能力，我们也相信，在未来的10年里面 ，AI 在汽车领域里面会是一个标配，它标配高等级自动驾驶可以在中国、可以在欧洲、可以在全球的各个城市里面自由的驾驶，且不光硬件标配，软件也应该标配，不应该把软件拿来做订阅跟收费，因为这样。 的话，一个汽车将来可以持续的 OTA， 在基于高等级自动驾驶能力的基础之上，可以快速的 OTA， 让底盘、整个车的 AI 能力都可以快速的 OTA， 使更多人体会到高阶的智能驾驶能力和更高阶的 AI 系统能力。所以，我们从小鹏的 P7+开始，会定义所有后面我们的汽车里面 AI 将会是标配。 那么我们在这个领域里面，我们怎么做到的？我们做到，大家会看到，在现在很多的高等级自动驾驶的汽车里面是有激光雷达的，但是小鹏的 P7+是全球第二家，也是中国的第一家不使用激光雷达能够做到高阶自动驾驶的汽车。那么为什么我们可以做到？因为小鹏的 P7+开始，我们会升级到小鹏的。 端到端的整个的大模型，且是在 AI 鹰眼的这样一个视觉方案。那么很多朋友会问，在过去的时间为什么需要一颗激光雷达？因为过去在算力跟模型不强的情况下，我们都会想到一个汽车只能看到远方在视觉里面大概30个左右的图像，但是新的端到端里面，我们 all input。 那么我们会看到一个很大的变化是，视觉会在未来的端端里面更适合做自动驾驶。所以不光在中国，我期待在明年的后年，在法律法规允许的区域，我们的希望知道无限城市、无限道路、无限路况逐步可以升级到有更好的自动驾驶可以用，并且好用。不光在自动驾驶的基础上，小鹏的 P7+还做到了在能耗上的巨大的技术创新。这是一款5米长的车，有3米的轴距，但是我们把能耗，大家可以看到做到了 WTP 是14.9千瓦每100公里，在 WTP 上，这个能耗上超过了非常多同行高端的电动汽车的标准。所以它意味着什么？用更少的电池，更好的技术能做到更远的续航。 这是一个技术的更新一代的前进。除了在技术领域，在 P7+上面做到了更前进，我们在 P7+里面也做到了一些很有趣的探索跟创新。也就是说，大家知道，在欧洲现在轿车的销售的比率是并不高的，但是在中国还很高。那么为什么在欧洲体系里面，我们看到？ 现在轿车并不多，旅行车更多 ，SUV 比例上还要多。我们上看到了一种趋势是，每一个人都希望自己的车有更大的空间。那么在原来的我们的概念里面，一个轿跑，它的后备箱空间和它的后座空间并不大，但是 但是脾气加做到了后备箱空间达到了700-800方的情况下，可以放33个20寸的行李箱到一个汽车里面去。记住，在一个轿跑里面去，我相信这是一个巨大的技术创新。那么我们在这一款车PG加还做了非常多跟行政豪华级轿车在顶配一样的舒适功能。这款车非常的安静，底盘调教了很平稳、很扎实、很舒适。这款车的四个座椅上面，我们全配了通风、加热，甚至包括按摩。它是全部是标配，不是选配的。我们期望让豪华行政上面的轿车的所有能力都在这台车上做到标配。很多朋友会问，小鹏，你们怎么能够在一个轿跑上做到这么大的空间？那么在这里，我想跟大家分享其中一点，因为小鹏的PG加用了全球最大的量产的16000吨重的压铸机，在整个的前保跟后保的一体式的铝压铸，我们将数百个零件压成了2个零件。那么这导致了